Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nature, a retired lecturer in metallurgy belonging to the Jat tribe of the Punjab, where the second anointed Christ Nanak appeared. And as you know, explained, Jats are number one Bhagat, are devotees of God. And when we are learned and speak the gospel, we speak gospel truth, we don't twist it. And number one twisters are people of the Khatri tribe who have twisted the books, corrupted the books. And the present bead are the Bible people are reading is highly corrupted. But they have produced so much darkness that nobody understand it. And you will see in the next, this one, that the people who have were beheaded, that means they have given their sacrifice for him to serve humanity or to become the servant of God in one way or the other. So they have nothing to do with secular property. They can't go back to their families. If they go back to their families, then they are imposters. So those people who you see them taking amrit in the Gurdwaras, Sikh temples, or in any other places, even the women are taking. Remember that not a single woman was baptized by Royal King Gobind Singh Ji. Only the men were baptized, not women. But you see the woman being baptized, that means all they are imposter. And all these imposters are made by satanic Khatris. Now, in here, dark age, you reap the reward of your conscience. If your conscience is dirty, then you suffer. Remember the conscience of the people of the Middle East, of the Judah tribe, they were the sons of Satan. That was not that dirty. When Jesus rebuked Judah Iscariot, he killed himself. The people of the Khatri tribe are shameless people. They have no conscience. They are not salt of the earth at all. So the way they will suffer when this tribulation period comes in 2012, they will suffer very badly. People are now crying about this attack on Gaza Strip by the Israeli people. When the fighting will take place in India, they will break all the records of humanity. They will be very cruel killing of the people. And that will reflect the degree of Satan's. So after they were beheaded and raised up again, and this miracle, when it was seen by everyone, they were all stunned and they were all amazed. And then they were taken into a tent. Tent means they are taken to the home of Akalpur, home of God, away from the eyes of the people. And they had the blue uniform of the Khalsa. Khalsas have specific uniform. They are not in mufti, are not in plain clothing. And then they all came in front of this, on the stage, and facing the public. And then Royal King Gobind Rai Ji asked them that he also want to be baptized by them. So then they baptized such a Pasha, Gobind Rai Ji, and then his name changed to Gobind Singh. So all those who were beheaded, they had their tribal surnames before. After beheading, those tribal surnames gone. They were replaced with the universal surname, Singh. So Singh, you don't, you see people putting Singh in their middle name, they are all degrading Royal King Gobind Rai Ji. So then they were called Singh. And that was their universal surname. Their family records were kept in a register, but to the world they were just given different names and also Singh, that was the common surname. So of these Khalsas, which they were, these Singhs are the Khalsas of the Third Panth. Of the Khalsas, those who went it had a tendency towards religious knowledge or preaching gospel. Those who wanted to become preachers, or royal priests. Sache Pasha Gobind Singh Ji sent them to Banaras. Banaras was the center of learning, as Jerusalem was in the Middle East. So when they went to Banaras to present themselves to their Pandits. Pandits mean the Pharisee and Sadducee sitting in the Banaras, who had the book knowledge. So when they presented themselves to them, and they asked them what tribes they are, because this knowledge of Brahman, of the Pandit, to make it to become a rabbi, another thing, you have to be of specific tribe. In the Middle East, it is of Levi tribe people do the job of a rabbi, of a priest. In the India, we have quite a few tribes who do the job of the Brahman, or the, of the rabbi. They are God and Sarsut, Mohial. There are so many difficult to count, because I have not that much knowledge how many tribes there are. However, those people, when they were none of those tribes, they were turned away. They were, no, you can't have it, this knowledge. This is a knowledge for the people who do the rabbinic jobs. Pandits become pandit in the mandir or in the temples. So they were turned away. So they went to Royal King Gobind Singh Ji and told him that they have turned us away. And then he said, okay, take this uniform off and put on the uniform of sadhus, fakirs. And they put, which is called sannyas. So they put on the dust-colored clothing of the sadhus, and then they went there. Because they had become the eunuchs for the kingdom of heaven, which is the apostles, or the fourth one, in which they are purely spiritual. Remember that I showed you the fourth stage where they are purely spiritual. So when they were purely spiritual, and then the tribal thing doesn't come in. So then, you know, those Pharisees in Banaras, or the rabbi in the Banaras, Pandit, then they taught them the Vedic knowledge of the Vedas. So then they became, they learned the knowledge to their best ability. And after they have learned the knowledge, because they had the knowledge of Sikhism, and then this knowledge of the Vedas was on their fingertips, but still it gave them a good exercise to grasp them, to know everything. Because when they are going to preach gospel, then there should not be any problem in explaining to the people the meaning of the Bani, or his word. So in the next video, I will explain what parts they played and how they were rejected, or how they were despised by the sons of Satan of Khatri tribe in India. So we have a great uphill work in India, because these Khatri tribes are too clever to be apprehended. God bless you.